Just feel right here, quick. It's like it's supposed to happen, this one right here.
There was a moment I decided to make this league go. I have run amateur leagues for 12 years and I've been tinkering around with the idea of running a pro league. Went to an NBA game and I saw a game with so many unnatural starts and stops. It was the exact opposite of flow.
There are two problems inherent in the standard NBA game.
One, the offensive players' 12 shots per game are divided over 3 hours and it is a struggle to stay hot. Two, the defensive players' efforts are spread out over these same 3 hours, causing the defense to be disproportionately strong.
If you think about it, 12 very great athletes, tall, big, lanky professionals, get to expend 48 minutes worth of energy spread out over 3 hours. That's too much time. And so what's happening is there isn't very much athleticism, there isn't too many fast breaks, there's a real unnaturalness to it. It's almost like if you were to take a game and divide it out over a day.
Julio wanted to bring the game into an hour and a half contest and make it an athletic event the way it was designed to be. A game that is drawn out over 3 hours can be entertaining, can produce highlights, but a game that lasts 1 hour and 30 minutes will be guaranteed to have more action, more athleticism, and more excitement.
The IBL style of play reminds me of good NBA level play with sort of that touch of and one. You've got the crowd frenzy, but you've got the talent of the ball players and stuff. It's a high-scoring league. It's players with a good feeling and love for each other in the game. And they get up and down the court and play not only just by the rules, but they play with a little flair.
Basketball fans want to see action. They want to see athleticism, in particular speed. Spectators want to see points, and they crave excitement. More speed, more points, more excitement.
What I'm trying to bring in as commissioner of the IBL is a brand of basketball that's brought back to the 1980s Los Angeles Lakers, early 90s UNLV Running Rebels. What made those games exciting is the same thing that the IBL's bringing. A bunch of guys between 6 foot and 6'8" running the floor like it's a track meet.
What the IBL tries to do is they try to bring the fan base into the league and bring it more close and up front and personal. Because there's no greater thrill than seeing some of your favorite athletes or someone that you admire and live vicariously through with their feet on the court, be able to sit down and just actually touch them or speak to them and stuff. And you can't do that nowadays with some of the pro players. You know, it just isn't set up for that. But the IBL is. When a kid walks away from a game, I hope that he walks away with that feeling, that passion that, hey, that could be me. You know, one day I could be in the IBL.
In September 2003, a test game was set up between Portland players and a Seattle team coached by the legendary Randy Redwine. The game featured IBL rules that eliminate dead time, rules designed to promote athleticism. The game had a high pace, the game had flow. The game was exciting. The final score of this test game was 137-136, and this game became the birth of the IBL. November 2004. 14 teams are officially set to play and 10 more cities are still being recruited. In April 2005, the International Basketball League will tip off. Is your city in? Are you ready?
It's supposed to happen, this one right here. Young.